Well, tomorrow marks 30 years since World AIDS Day began to raise awareness about the global AIDS crisis.
And here at home, the Black AIDS Institute will host its annual gala honoring those fighting on the front lines against AIDS and HIV. And joining us right now is the Institute's founder, Phill Wilson. Welcome. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
Sounds like quite an event tomorrow night.
It is. We're very, very excited. This is the 18th annual Heroes in the Struggle Gala. It is a tribute to individuals and organizations who are on the front line in the fight against HIV and AIDS. You know, AIDS is not in the media as much as it used to be, but it's not over.
Who are some of the honorees?
We're honoring remarkable people. Lettucey, the R&B and neo soul singer. Gabby Sidibe from Empire. Billy Porter from Pose and Angels in America. We're honoring Dr. David Melbranch, who is a physician from Atlanta. Gabe Maldonado, who is a young HIV positive AIDS activist right here in Southern California. And Essence Magazine.
Why did you start this organization?
We started this organization in 1998, primarily because we looked at the disproportionate impact that HIV is having on Black and Brown and other people of color. And we felt like there needed to be an organization that focused exclusively on where the epidemic was. And so over the last 20 years, we have engaged and mobilized Black communities all over this country to say, this is a problem impacting us. Because in the beginning, folks didn't believe it was their problem. Folks thought it was all about just white gay men. And so we've been engaging Black folks, and we've been trying to move the needle to end the AIDS epidemic.
You probably just answered the next question. You're stepping down as a CEO after this year.
I am.
What you just said, is that your legacy, do you feel?
I think so. That you know, in 2018, we have the tools to end the AIDS epidemic, okay? But those tools don't matter if you don't use them effectively, efficiently, and universally. And there's a light at the end of the tunnel. Our challenge is finding a way to get there. And I think that we're closer to that now than we were in the past.
Empire star Jesse Smollett.
Yes.
That's a big deal. He's hosting tomorrow night.
He is. There's a star-studded event at the California African American Museum. This is the second year in a row that Jesse Smollett has been the event chair. He's also the host. He's co-hosting, actually, with his sister, Journey Smollett, who is another shining star. So it's going to be an exciting evening. We have celebrities from all over the country, and it's going to be neat.
If people can't actually go to this event, but they want to find out about services that you guys offer, can you enlighten us on that?
We need folks every single day. You know, everyone has a role to play, and everyone needs to play that role. They can go to www.blackaids.org, and they can find out how to get involved. We have three clinics here in Southern Los Angeles, two in Leimert Park, and one in the Pico Union area right by MacArthur Park.
Great.
All right.
Thank you so much. You look very dapper.
Well, thank you.
All right. Good luck tomorrow night. And once again, Heroes in the Struggle is being hosted by Empire star Jesse Smollett and produced by Deondray Gossfield and Quincy LeNear Gossfield. It takes place tomorrow night at the California African American Museum. Tickets still available and can be purchased at blackaids.org.
All right.